Hey guys, Jake and Zach here from 8020 Media. We've got an exciting video for you guys today. We are kicking off our 135i single turbo build series. We've got our N54 135 here behind us, and the majority of the parts or major parts here on the table, and we are going to be starting the process of turning this into a 700 plus wheel horsepower N54. So right off the bat, the main highlight of this build here is the Precision 6266 Turbo from Speedtech. They're able to make above 750 wheel horsepower if you push the limits of that size turbo. But again, the goal here is around 700 wheel horsepower, so should be plenty of turbo to reach those goals. So I'll let Jake jump in here with a quick overview of the next build videos that we'll be doing on the 135.
So we're going to be doing a full build series here that includes multiple videos as we build this ourselves. Obviously, the car is back here on the lift and completely taken apart right now. The next video that we film is going to be on preventative maintenance, and then we'll do a couple more videos on fueling to talk about our fueling setup as well as general fueling setups for single turbo and twin turbo upgrades. We'll do a video of us mounting the turbo in place, and then we'll do one later on with tuning. And once we finish these initial videos of us actually building the car, we'll have some pretty fun content coming along. We're going to take this and Zach's 335i to the dyno and dyno the two against each other. And then once we get some warmer weather here in Denver, we'll go ahead and get these things out to the track and put up the single turbo versus twin turbo test. And so we'll have some pretty fun N54 videos and content coming down the pipeline the next month or two. So please go ahead and subscribe to the channel and follow along with this. Your support means everything. We really want to be able to provide more build series like this and do more builds. And so the more support that we get, the more viewership, the easier it is for us to be able to continue to create this content that's a little bit more exciting for us and exciting for you guys. With that being said, we'll go ahead and jump a little bit more deep into the parts overview or build sheet here. All right, so starting with the basics here, that is my N54 135i behind there. I bought it back in 2017. It took me about 6 months to find it because I was looking for a 6-speed manual. I wanted a coupe and not a convertible. And I also wanted black, white, or blue. Not a huge fan of red or silver or anything like that. And so it was a pretty specific car that I was looking for. And they did not make a whole lot of these 135s that were manuals and coupes in the colors that I wanted. And in addition to that, I didn't want a high mileage one. This was 2017, so a lot of these had already been on the road for 8 to 10 years and had 100,000 plus miles on it. But I wanted something that was low mileage. And so I waited around for about 6 months until I found this. I think it was in Idaho, and it had about 32,000 miles on it. So I bought it sight unseen and had it shipped to me in Texas. I've had it ever since then, but I haven't really done that much to it over the last 6 years. It has a couple basic bolt-ons done to it right now. It's got some downpipes on it, intakes, and then a JB4 tune. But I'd never really done a whole lot more than that because I'd sort of been waiting for a moment like this to where we kind of went all out and did a full build on it. I didn't want to continue to put mods and put money into it, knowing that eventually down the road we were going to end up going single turbo and not being able to use the majority of the parts that I'd already put onto it. And so that covers it for what we're starting with here. It's a pretty clean slate, not a whole lot of existing mods that have been done to it. Did have some pretty bad oil leaks. The intake valves had never been cleaned. So that was the preventative maintenance that I already did to it in preparation for what we have here.
Again, all of that stuff about the preventative maintenance will be coming up in the next video, and we'll have more details on some of the preventative maintenance and things that you should do to the N54 before going ahead and throwing a big upgrade like a single turbo or upgraded twin turbos on the car.
Yep. Our build videos coming up after this are going to be part updates of me and Zach working on the car and actually putting the parts in place, and then also part informational for anyone else that's looking to do a single turbo build. And so we'll cover fueling
and we'll cover different turbo setups in case you're looking to make less power, more power, etc. But to jump into the build list here, like Zach mentioned, really the highlight here is the Precision Turbo 6266. I know with a single turbo, you can put down a lot more than 750 wheel horsepower, but obviously there's a lot more that goes into that from a build standpoint as well as from a cost standpoint. And so we aren't necessarily going for a budget build here, but we're also not going for a full-blown 900 wheel horsepower plus build, just since at some point that's going to require a built motor, which is a pretty expensive next step to take. And so we wanted to go ahead and stick with what we think is going to be a pretty reliable single turbo setup that can consistently put down around 650 to 700 wheel horsepower, hopefully without running into any major issues with engine internals. So you can go bigger, but we feel pretty good about 700 wheel horsepower. And so that's the goal, more or less, with what we're trying to do here, so that we don't have to get into some of those more serious modifications, because the last thing that we're going to do is be like all of those other people out there that buy N54s, do no maintenance on it, and then try to put as much power into it as they can, and then 2 months later, they're like, the N54 is so unreliable, you know, I put a single turbo on it, was running 30 PSI of boost, and the engine blew up. So we're building it the right way, keeping things within reasonable limits so that we don't run into any issues with the motor, the block, the internals. So that's the high-level overview and the turbo setup that we're running here. So I'll go ahead and let Zach talk a little bit about fueling and tuning.
And again, this was just one final comment on the turbo kit. It was the Speedtech 6266 kit. So a couple of those parts sitting around, the cast manifold, the downpipe here. Of course, tons of other little bolts and accessories for all of this stuff, like the fueling mods that I'll touch on in a moment here. Lots of stuff that isn't shown, so there are a lot of other little bits and pieces to this build. These are just the bigger items from the project. But anyway, jumping right into fueling mods, we went with the Phoenix intake manifold from Berger Motorsports. And with that, we got the 750cc fuel injectors. So the good deal with the Berger tuning Phoenix manifold is it's relatively inexpensive and it does simplify a lot of things when it comes to fueling, as opposed to just going for the port injection rail. There are some benefits to either, but we went for the full manifold here, same setup we have on the 335i, and that's worked with great success, so figured we'll stick with that route again. We also have the dual low pressure fuel pumps, and those are from, I think we got that from Precision Racework, and it's the DIY stage 3 kit, so you can save a bit of money. Requires a little bit of extra work, so when we pull that fuel pump out, we'll have to use the stock bucket and do a little bit of the wiring and set up on our own, but a good way to save a couple bucks on that. One final note, probably missing a thing or two with fueling here, but again, we'll do a more informational full video on N54 fueling for single turbos, twin turbo upgrades, different power goals, so on and so forth. But again, that stage 3 dual low pressure fuel pump, they're a Walbro 450 pumps, although now they have rebranded to TI Automotive. Last major part fueling wise, we have the JB4 port injection controller. So we've had these N54s for ages, since back in the day when the JB4s were a lot more popular. I know they aren't quite as appealing to some nowadays, but they do make the setup fairly simple. Already has a JB4 on it again, so that JB4 port injection controller is very simple. Tying into that tuning, at least starting off when we first get everything installed, I think we'll just go ahead and do the Berger Motorsports off-the-shelf map for the single turbo upgrades. Just kind of get it dialed in at first with that, make sure everything's running well, and then after that, we'll go ahead and go for custom tuning just to get everything dialed in even more, just make sure the tuning is safe and everything is looking good with the car. So I think that just about covers everything with fueling and tuning. And again, we'll have more videos about that stuff coming up in the future where we can really dive in more depth into those specific details.
Well, I think for the most part, that wraps it up on our intro video here. Like I mentioned at the start of it, this is really the content that we want to be creating for you guys. We have a couple other cool cars that we have not showcased on this channel yet. Like Zach mentioned, he does have a 335i. It has upgraded twin turbos on it. But we also bought a couple cars probably about 6 months ago. We have a pretty cool old E30 as well as a Miata over here. And we want to do some build videos with that, kind of turn those into semi-track cars and put them up on the track against each other. But as you can imagine,
modifications like this, doing build series are pretty expensive. Between those two cars and the turbo setups that we have going here, we're easily already 20 grand plus, probably 25 grand plus since I spent some money on the Miata already. But doing these types of videos is pretty expensive, and we really would appreciate your guys' support as we continue to grow our channel so that we can create more fun and entertaining content like this and hopefully do some crazier builds in the future.